Recently, 81-year-old Senator Mitch McConnell suffered a medical incident that caused him to freeze up in front of reporters. It's the second time that's happened to him in as many months. And how did MSNBC report on the incident this morning? Well, by attacking a Democratic congressman who actually called for term limits and said something that I would argue is common sense. So Representative Dean Phillips, again, a Democrat, said, for goodness sake, the family, friends, and staff of Senators Feinstein and McConnell, and of course Feinstein is a Democratic senator, are doing them and our country a tremendous disservice. It's time for term limits for Congress and the Supreme Court and some basic human decency. I mean, look, honestly, I think that's even a mild statement. And I totally agree, especially with that last part about human decency. I do not enjoy watching any human being, even senators I dislike, suffer publicly from these medical incidents. But nonetheless, you might think that's a pretty inoffensive statement. However, Symone Sanders-Townsend, who actually worked on Biden's campaign, was not happy with that comment at all. Let's take a look.
I have had the pleasure of meeting and speaking with Congressman Dean Phillips, and he is a lovely gentleman. But I do think that there are things that we say on the internet that we would not dare say in the presence of the people with whom we are discussing. The reality is this. I watched that video about two times today of Senator McConnell, and my heart broke for him, for his family, for the people that know him very well. He is a father, a grandfather, and I do hope that he is absolutely okay. I've said the same thing about Senator Feinstein here. But, you know, to try to capitalize on the moment and boost yourself up in this moment, saying things that are just never going to come to fruition. In order for term limits to happen in Congress, the people who would be term limited would need to vote for that. That's not gonna happen. Okay, so if you want some term limits, there's maybe some state-based ways to go about it potentially. I don't know, I haven't looked into the law, but what he is talking about is not based in fact.
Cenk is ready to go, so I'm just gonna go to you, Cenk.
Yeah, so look, I'll get to Mitch McConnell in a second and what we should do about him freezing all the time, and Feinstein too. So, but first I want to tell you why Symone Sanders is doing this. So she's attacking a fellow Democrat. That's the most verboten thing there is in Washington. You can't do that. If a progressive did that, they'd remove their heads. And on MSNBC, they would go ballistic if a progressive did that. But Symone Sanders now is fully part of the establishment, worked for Kamala Harris, Joe Biden, etc. So why is she out there attacking a fellow Democrat? Because Dean Phillips said that he might run against Joe Biden for president. Oh no, they gotta attack him, and now all of a sudden he's a bad guy. Also, they're trying to protect not Mitch McConnell, but Dianne Feinstein. And Dianne Feinstein, look, we can show you the picture, is being led around by Nancy Pelosi's daughter. Her mental ailment, whatever it is so far advanced, she has absolutely no idea what's going on. The person with the red arrow next to it is Pelosi's daughter,
yeah,
and
Nancy
she now
Kareen.
Runs. And according to reporting, she now runs Feinstein's office. So Pelosi has a seat in the House and in the Senate. So they don't want to take that away. And if you talk about McConnell, people are going to talk about Feinstein. And then the third part of it is that Joe Biden genuinely loves Mitch McConnell.
Yeah, he can't stop talking about how they're friends. In fact, let's go to the next video because it'll show you exactly what we're referring to.
By the way, I just heard literally coming out. And Mitch is a friend, as you know, not a joke. We always, I know people don't believe that case, but we have disagreements politically, but he's a good friend. And so I'm gonna try to get in touch with him later this afternoon. I don't know enough to know.
Do you think he's
Thank you.
Served and should run for the election?
Are you running?
I am not, sir.
Okay, all right, thank you.
Nice dodge there. Obviously, the reporter was not asking about Mayorkas, asking about.
I don't know if that was a dodge. I don't know. I'm gonna. If you're being kind, you'll chalk it up as a really bad joke, like a weird joke. But if when we're talking about Mitch McConnell freezing up and how these people are too old, when you turn to a random cabinet member and ask him if he's running, it doesn't send the right message. That was super weird at the end. But more importantly, the beginning where. Brother, nobody thinks it's a joke. We know you love McConnell. We know you love cutting deals with Republicans.
Mitch McConnell is my friend.
That's what he whispers all the time. Mitch McConnell's my friend. Okay, we know that's the goddamn problem. You love him so much. And of course, guys, Biden is super old. That's why Democratic officials are on MSNBC going, not a big deal about Mitch McConnell, not a big deal. And Dean Phillips shouldn't be saying that about Feinstein or McConnell.
But Cenk, finish your thought in regard to why it is that Nancy Pelosi's daughter is now like a caretaker for Feinstein, why it is that the Democratic establishment isn't pressuring, honestly at this point, Feinstein's family to essentially get her to resign. What would happen if, let's say, Feinstein were to resign prior to her term being up?
So in California, we have, of course, a Democratic governor, and the Democratic governor would appoint her replacement. And he has said on the record that he wanted to appoint, if it ever came to it, a black woman to the post. Now, here's the problem. The most logical black woman by a landslide is Barbara Lee, who's actually running for that Senate seat and is a longtime Democrat in the House. The problem is she's a progressive. And they don't want to put a progressive in that seat. They want to put Adam Schiff in that
seat. Exactly.
So that's why they're like, no, keep wheeling around. Besides Pelosi, Feinstein, what's the difference? We control the seat anyway.
It's so sick. It's so sick. It's so disgusting. It's so unfair and so sick in regard to the treatment of Dianne Feinstein. Okay. And it's sick in regard to essentially like playing kingmaker, right? That's what they're doing here. No. We want to prevent Gavin Newsom from upholding his promise, you know, to essentially fill that seat with an African-American woman in this case. And look, usually when they make that statement, they'll pick someone who's like-minded, an establishment individual who's gonna go along with their games and their schemes. Barbara Lee might not go along with all of their games and their schemes, which is why they wanna prevent her from sitting in that seat and instead, you know, continue propping up Adam Schiff, who's gonna play ball.
Oh, of course, that's the whole point of Adam Schiff, is to play ball, not with Gavin Newsom, but with the donors.
Yes.
That's what this is all about, guys. And it is equally true for the Democrats and the Republicans. Why is Mitch McConnell not out? That's super embarrassing. He keeps freezing. The first time was for 19 brutal seconds. This time it was for 30 endless seconds. I couldn't believe how long he was frozen there. And then his staff comes in, totally not surprised. And they're like, okay, Senator, and they're not like, whoa, no, etc. How many times does he freeze when he's not on camera? And they keep wheeling this guy out. Why? Because Mitch McConnell has raised $1 billion for Republicans.
You know, it is interesting though, because there is one difference between the Democratic Party and the Republican Party. While someone like Dean Phillips, I guess in this context, was courageous enough to speak out against what's going on. You know, on the Republican side, you have multiple Republican members of Congress who are like, this isn't good, right? In fact, right now in the Senate, Republicans are considering meeting internally to discuss what they should do about this, if they do anything at all. So there's nothing concrete or written in stone on that. But publicly, you have Matt Gaetz, you know, commenting publicly about the Mitch McConnell situation simply with yikes. He shared an article about the story. And then Marjorie Greene also saying severe aging health issues and or mental health incompetence in our nation's leaders must be addressed. Biden, McConnell, Feinstein, and Fetterman are examples of people who are not fit for office, and it's time to be serious about it. Fetterman obviously is not elderly. He suffered a stroke, and that is what she's referring to there.
Fetterman, putting him in that group is totally unfair because he's mentally completely fine. He's having trouble speaking. It happens after strokes, and it doesn't mean that he's mentally impaired at all. So don't put him in that list. But I don't even mind if you put Biden on that list. Okay. Well, in fact, I'm the one who just pointed out that super weird thing he just said. We're being honest with you guys. Fetterman doesn't belong in that list. But the other three, I mean, the two of them obvious, McConnell and Feinstein. And Biden has his moments, okay? But he's being super stubborn and wants to run anyway. But on Marjorie Taylor Greene, I should also explain this. She went on to say in that same statement, we should use the 25th Amendment. On senators? It's for the president, you schmuck. And so she just has no idea what she's talking about. Thanks for watching the Young Turks. Really appreciate it. Another way to show support is through YouTube memberships. You'll get to interact with us more. There's live chat emojis, badges, You've got emojis of me, Anna, John, JR. So those are super fun. But you also get playback of our exclusive member only shows and specials right after they air. So all of that, all you gotta do is click that join button right underneath the video. Thank you.